In what could be one of the most decisive speeches on Europe since World War II, British Prime Minister David Cameron on Friday will set out his plans to reshape the future of Britain in the EU. Facing mounting pressure from the Eurosceptic side of his own Conservative Party, Cameron aims at bringing back some of the powers that Brussels currently holds to Westminster. Many EU leaders have already criticized Cameron's intentions. EU Council President Herman Van Rompuy has said that Mr. Cameron cannot cherry-pick what EU policies he can sign up to. MEPs also warn that Cameron's plans could undermine the single market.
We need one European Union, a single European Union, and not a European Union a la carte, as we have today, with opt-ins and opt-outs and derogations and exceptions and rebates. If you can pick and choose, what shall be left of the single market? If the French, for example, saying, oh, we like industrial policy, we don't like the competition rules. Or the Germans are saying, oh, we like the single market in goods, but not the single market in services. What shall be left of the single market? Let's be honest, and let Mr. Cameron be honest about it. A renegotiation, as he wants, means, in fact, either a Brexit or the end of the single market, and in fact, the end of the European Union.
Adding to the criticism of the European Parliament, Austrian Chancellor Werner Faymann accused the British Premier of sending mixed messages in his European approach.
Nur wenn wir diese Solidarität, die eigentlich Europa auszeichnen sollte, als ein Modell, das im Unterschied zu anderen Kontinenten die Demokratie, die Freiheit, aber auch das Sozialwesen als besonders bedeutend einstuft und lebt. Diese Solidarität darf nicht auf nationale Grenzen, sondern muss auf das gemeinsame Europa ausgedehnt werden. Es kann uns nur gemeinsam gut oder gemeinsam schlecht gehen.
Expectations are that Cameron aims to regain control in areas like immigration and employment, and that if successful, he would put this new UK-EU relationship to a referendum. But reforms can only be made if the EU treaty is reopened, something that other EU leaders have already warned is not planned anytime soon.
I don't see an issue of opening a treaty change for any individual country, because you open the floodgates for requirements for changes, possibly for many others. But I work with our colleagues in Britain as closely as we can, and we value them as members of the European Union. We would see it as being disastrous were a country like Britain to leave the Union.
Britain joined the European Union in 1973. Since then, it has negotiated a number of opt-outs from key EU policies. The country is not part of the Eurozone and has not signed Free Border Schengen Treaty.